What's up, y'all? Your girl Sydney B with Magic 94.5. We're here at the Platinum Comedy Tour right here at the Verizon Theater in Grand Prairie. And with me,
What's
D.A.
up?
Davis.
Hey, girl, how you doing?
I'm doing good. How you doing?
I feel good. I'm comfortable.
All right.
I got my Steven Seagal outfit from Hard to Kill, 1980s movies. I got my Bruce Leroy braids going on.
You know I was gonna ask you about the braids.
My hair is real crazy and big. Uh-huh. And I was getting ready to film a movie. It's called Gully. Uh-huh. And I play like this crazy dad or whatever, and I wanted to do something different on film.
Uh-huh.
So I had them, my original braids were like just, you know, nappy, crazy, like all over the place. And then after I saw it, I said, you know, I haven't braided my hair in 18 years, let me go and get some regular braids.
And how was that sitting there getting your hair braided?
It took forever. I know why. Hey, that's why they're looking back at me now. I want to take them out and get them again. But yeah, it's all right. You should have seen everybody when I walked the tour, though. Everybody.
They're like, well, what's going on?
Yeah, yeah. Trying to relive your life, bro. But yeah.
So you've been in Dallas. What you been up to since you've been in town?
Asleep.
Exactly.
I slept all day. That's probably why I look a little sleepy. I'm woke, but I had a nice come. I'm always here. I come to Dallas a lot, so I didn't want to go sightseeing and all that. Everybody invited me to the day parties and pool. I was like, let me just relax for a minute because I'm going on vacation this week.
All right. So, but you getting ready to go on stage?
I am. We're on stage.
Okay.
Yeah, gonna go up there and have some fun. I never know how I'm feeling or what joke I'm gonna say first or. But I just know, you know, it's instant gratification for me. Mm-hmm. I'm up there trying to get it.
So, you know, everybody's talking about Kanye West. You know, I cannot let you go without getting your opinion on Kanye West thinking slavery is a choice. What do you think about what's going on with him?
Well, maybe in that context, he was talking to himself, saying he's choosing to be enslaved in whatever mindset he's in right now.
Uh-huh.
Maybe years ago we would have, you know, communicated on the phone better about it. But I don't think there's no one right directly next to him saying to filter out the conversation or get it to where he's somebody need a speaking somebody to speak for you. You know what I mean? So that's why mediators are there. So I believe he needs to keep somebody like that with him so they can deliver the information the way he wants to and it's never misconstrued. Because I understand what he's saying as far as freedom of speech, and I know what he means. He's saying, why didn't we uproar as slaves? Mm-hmm. But the same way, why don't prisons get taken over like daily?
Absolutely.
It's way more prisoners. But it's also the fear. You know, you got the fear, I might get shot. Somebody may not revolt with me. Somebody may. So I think that I know where he's going with it, but sometimes wording wise, you got to be able to deliver the information. Mm-hmm. A lot of arguments and stuff would be different if people just reworded it. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So as far as his mental capacity, I don't know much because I haven't, like I said, been around him in a long time. I know that he definitely misses his mom. I know that's always.
I think that's clear. That
and
he
I don't think. And I don't think he goes and talks to nobody. Mm-hmm. I don't think he goes like to a therapist. I don't think of black people. We don't ever think we need therapists anyway.
Mm-hmm.
But we missing a lot of the. His mom's gone. I'm not sure. I think his grandma's gone too. I don't think there's nobody. And you know, back in the day, we had somebody to talk to like that. That was our therapist. Even your drunk uncle was a therapist. And I don't think there's nobody older like an OG around him, some kind of form of fashion to say. Talk to me and let me tell you what they might not tell him exactly how to feel because you can't tell somebody how to feel, but they'll be able to give him some information as far as guidance of how to deal with it.
But he has all those Kardashians around him.
Yeah, that's not information. I mean, you got to find, I mean, not saying that they're not smart either because they rode a train all the way to superstardom, so I would never doubt them. I don't say they're not smart. I'm not going to say
I think those women are really smart.
Yeah, I'm not going to say that him, just the way that they go about things as far as like how they do the media and how they do it, all it's like they're the new tabloids every day, you know. But I just think, like I said, it's just that thing missing, man. So I'm saying he loved Trump. I understand it. Yeah, I do. He can say he loves somebody and not agree with them. I believe that every day we do that with our family.
Absolutely.
And people who have said Trump's name, we made that man like that. People said Trump's name. So many rappers said his name in raps before he made it as president. Now he's president. And that's like, you know.
You don't have anything
to do with him.
Yeah.
You know, you put him, but don't put him somewhere on a pedestal in one position and don't think they won't parallel that to get somewhere else.
Mm-hmm.
You can't do it. It's like bring your cousin up. You like having your grimy cousin around you. When you want to go fight somebody, you're like, you got somebody with you that want to fight. But the minute he act like that when you don't want him to, you're like, hey, that ain't my cousin. You know, that ain't my sister. It's that thing. I don't agree with nothing Trump does as president.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know nothing about finances. I know the financial side of what he's saying he's doing for the community. I don't like how he downplays our president, you know what I'm saying, and the history of presidents. I'm not a smart guy, but he does, until what Trump does, he does make me feel like anybody can be president.
Yeah, I think if he's showing
that. Anybody open doors, it feels like a movie we're watching, you know, so. I don't know. What does D-Ray know?
you know a lot, okay? Well, thank you so much for stopping by. Now, you got to get ready.
Yeah, I'm going to go get ready. You know what I'm saying? I'm going on stage absolutely naked. So,
be ready for that.
Now, that's going to be funny.